years. So I'm happy that we can have the hackathon this year again. DBCRS have focus on building an infrastructure which makes an effective use of life science databases in an integrated way by using the smart technology. As part of the effort, we have been developing important data in our data and ontologies for describing organism-level information of microbial species. So, I will focus on two topics in this presentation. The first is our effort for constructing microbial strain information, which is provided by two institutions in Japan. The second is another effort for constructing ontology for microbial phenotype. So please keep in mind these two keywords. One is microbial strain and phenotype. So we also have several other targets in our project, but today I will focus on only these two topics. So first topic is microbial strain. For the experimental biologist, cultured microbial strains, for example, freeze stock, are kept in several institutions, which are called Biological Resource Center, BRC. And this video shows BRCs in Japan. Each bar shows the number of strains and the breakdown by an organism classification in each center. We have collaborated with NIT Biological Research Center and NIT Biological Research Center in DRC, which can have the biggest culture collection of microbial strain in the world. We also have a good collaboration with WIKEN, Japan Collection of Microorganisms, JCM. They kindly provided us organism mental information of cultured strains, which they are maintaining. So at the start of our project, we have started to create RDF for such information. So for creating important data on microbial strains, we needed an ontology for describing information on cultured microbial strains. So therefore, I have developed an ontology named MCCV, which stands for Microbial Culture Collection Vocabulary for the purpose. I have already registered this ontology in BioPortal. This is so far submitted in private mode, but we will open it in public mode in the near future. And this figure shows the minimum dataset description defined by Global Catalog of Microorganisms. At the first step, I have developed the predicate terms in MCCV ontology to be able to describe these data standards. By using these predicates, we have created important data or information on cultured microbial strains in to Biological Research Center in DRC and JCM. So as a result, we created some important data. This table shows the number of RBF which describes the GCM minimum dataset and the information on culture microbial strain by using MCCV approach. And please be reminded that our purpose is to link genomic information and organism information on my blog. But we found that there are a lot of inconsistent links between strains and taxonomy ID when we try to make a one-to-one correspondence. One of the reasons is MCBI taxonomy ID seems to be designed for species level but strain level. For some of these issues, we created some R properties to describe relationships between microbial strains and taxonomy ID. These properties work as a kind of evidence code. So each property shows a link between strains and taxonomy ID based on a different criteria. So as a result, MCCV allow us to link taxonomy ID and strain RDL. So next topic. So next topic is phenotypes of microbes. Phenotype is an important knowledge in biological research, especially in microbes. Phenotype have been used for species identification. So therefore, a large amount of valuable information on microbial phenotype have been described in research papers and databases such as Bold. So for creating a link open data on microbial phenotype, I have developed an ontology named MPO, which stands for microbial phenotype ontology. So to start with, I have collected the ontology terms from description in the entries of Google database. So this is the part of MPO ontology. Now, this ontology consists of 142 terms about microbial phenotype. And this figure shows an example of MPO. Right figure shows microbial arrangement, and left figure shows the corresponding ontology terms. And this table shows the number of RPF, which links between each phenotype group and microbial species. So as a result, MPO allow us to link taxonomy ID and phenotype RDF. We also have other targets such as environment or microbial habitat, or culture medium, or infectious disease. Thank you for the time.